letters, but let's enjoy some peace. I'm going to recite a little correspondence from the idiot in charge of Mafra police station, Anthony Descent. Good afternoon, Stuart. This is the letter, obviously, but you know, rather than you staring at that boring shit, look at this pretty shit. Isn't that nice? Good afternoon, Stuart. To introduce myself, I am the officer in charge of Mafra Police Station, and as such, I am the supervisor of Senior Constable Darcy, who I assume is the police member you are referring to in your email. I am assuming, again, the SS is a typo instead of SC. Couldn't really care about their ranks, honestly. Firstly, I would like to say that any allegation of misconduct by Senior Constable Darcy be directed to me, and I will investigate the matter further. In saying that, Senior Constable Darcy is one of the most respected, polite, courteous, and high-performing police members in the Wellington Police Service area. These traits have been identified by not only other police members, but also numerous members of the civilian community. I hate how all these prats refer to us as civilians. They call us civvies. You know, just a name they throw around. No respect for the people that pay them. I have absolutely no issue with how Senior Constable Darcy has handled this matter to date, and the suggestion that Senior Constable Darcy acted out of personal spite is unfair and incorrect. Of course it is, because you're the dick in charge, right? The incident you refer to, where police members attended your address in Newry on the 14th of the 4th of 2021, was at the direction of myself, based on the fact you have an outstanding warrant for your arrest. This warrant was issued at the Sale Magistrate Court. Yeah, by a magistrate that happened to be caught out assisting the police in trying to get a guilty charge on some fucking falsified charges. So, load of shit. By the magistrate, as you failed to attend court. Yes, that bit too is to do with the fact that they didn't send me shit until the last minute. Like, literally a week before court. It's all paperwork supposed to be there 2 weeks before. The police dicked around. They could have just mailed it to me at any point, and they waited a week until prior to court. Okay, let's back to the dickhead. I can assure you this is a routine practice where we regularly seek out people with warrants. At times, there can be many in our area. In an effort to have the warrants executed with the accused person bailed with a new court date, this process is normally a very simple one. In the vast majority of cases, there are no issues. Yeah, of course, but you know, they don't have you prats caught out for fucking corruption. Further to this, I was one of the members that attended the Newry address. I knocked on the door and announced that police were present and that we had a warrant for your arrest. Amanda opened the door and let us in without any issue. Funny that. She seemed to have an issue according to what she told me. And it was about you guys, not me. I explained to Amanda, talked over her, what was happening, and she did not have any issue with what was happening. I strongly object to any assertion that there was any harassment to Amanda during this time. Well, you can strongly object to everything you like. We got you on video, you fuck, because the house is full of cameras. You are also incorrect when you query why we didn't have a search warrant. Yeah, you know, notice how they're big mouthpieces about how they know everything, right? The warrant for your arrest, remembering this was issued by a magistrate, we won't put corrupt in front of that, right? States police are authorized to break, enter, and search any place where the person named is suspected to be, and bring that person before the court. I had a copy of the warrant when I attended the address. We did not require a search warrant to search the property. You require permission and that, considering I've told you fucks a dozen times. I don't live with Amanda. We've had separate living arrangements for fucking decades. You guys are fuckwits. In relation to your suggestion that the number of police who attended the address was ridiculous, mind you, six. Six police, two police cars, right? It's a real piggy's day out. A waste of manpower and pointless overkill, I would suggest myself and other police supervisors would be the best people to decide what police resources are used where and when. Yeah, beating up people who are protesting. It seems to be, you guys are fucking legends, aren't you? In relation to your phone, I think he means in. This has been seized as an exhibit and as such will be retained lawfully in possession of police until the matter is finalised at court, including the ensuing 28-day appeal process. In other words, they want to hang on to it because what they're pushing for is to delete any recordings on it. That's their specific request with this. And it's purely to cover their ass. Okay, here's fuckwit again. In conclusion, I will be as clear and concise as I possibly can be. Warrants for arrest remain active indefinitely. In order to have this matter raised as soon as possible, the following needs to happen. 1. You can present yourself either here at Maffra Police Station or any police station within the state of Victoria, where you will be placed under arrest at the warrant will be executed. You will then be bailed to attend court at a date to be determined. At this point, you will be released from custody and the police will no longer be looking for you. This whole process will take approximately 10 minutes. I can assure you this is our preferred method of having the warrant dealt with. Nah, I think previously you held me at a police station for 2 hours just for the fun of it, but you know, and that wasn't misconduct either. You guys are fuckwits. Until you present yourself to a police station, I can assure you the police will continue to attend any place where you may be. Good luck, boys. Any place where you may be, and search that place in order to execute the warrant. This may happen at any time of the day or night. My advice is that the first option would be the best outcome. Not only for police, yeah, because you lazy cunts can just sit there, right? But would create less stress for yourself and anyone else who may be living with you. Victoria Police will continue to pursue this matter until it has been finalised in court. Of course you will, because you want to protect your fucking corrupt asses. If you are seeking any documents, body-worn cam, footage, or any other thing in relation to police attending your address, you can make an application through Freedom of Information for the items you feel you require. Well, it's funny because you send the application to Freedom of Information, then they send it to the cop to approve it. So why don't you just send it to the cop? It's like pointless paperwork to buy them time. You know, that's what criminals do, isn't it? Like, look at fucking Clive Palmer and all of them when they don't want to get caught out. They just drag it on for ages and ages and then try and pull the argument. This happened ages ago. How can we remember? Okay, we'll continue back to Dickhead. Finally, can I ask that any further inquiries in relation to your outstanding warrant be directed to myself rather than Senior Constable Darcy? Well, why'd you throw in front of the bus then, you fucking chauvinistic piece of shit? As I will be now the investigating member. Hooray! An incompetent dick-nosed fuck is in charge of my case again. Woohoo! I am more than happy to discuss this matter further with you in person if you desire. Regards, Anthony Descent. You wouldn't want to be on the record, would you? Too bad for that, mate. I'm going to give you a call and we're going to record the conversation, all right? Fucking dickheads. Yep, well, you know, this is how they waste their time and resources. He probably thought he was really clever doing that, and as usual, it was just a couple of hours after me sending him the email. So I doubt he tried to review or comprehend anything. You know, maybe he should have gone over his own body cam footage, but I'm tipping he didn't have body cams on because they were around there just to shock and intimidate. Amanda tried to talk to them and they just kept shutting her off. And like typical stupid pigs, she mentions about her ex-partner, like not me, but her other ex from a long time ago who she has a daughter with, having a gun. And their ears spike and go, what, Stuart's got a gun? That's how incompetent and fucking clueless these fuckwits are. It's like, you know, expecting a dog to do a math quiz because you offer it dog treats. But you know, they'll be looking right. Enjoy the search. It's a nice place. Get to know it. Like, I hope the pigs appreciate what I'm doing for them, giving them a fucking vacation. Well, I better go get to calling this dickhead, huh?